this is the question. They will be asking to solve this LPP by using the simplex method. Okay, so they will just say simplex method. They will not say a tabular form. Okay, so always it will be a tabular form only. Now, when we are doing this, our solution start always by converting these inequalities into the equalities, right? So that is what we need to do. So when we'll do, it should start with maximize z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2 plus, we have to write further, but before that what we'll do, we'll convert this first equation. See here, less than equal to is there. So for this less than equal to, we need to add slack variable. So what we'll say, x1 plus x2 plus x3 should be equal to, now it is equal to 10. So this first conversion of first constraint. For the second constraint, see, there are only x1 and x2. There are only two decision variables. After that, whatever we'll take, all slack variables. Okay. So now we'll take x3. We have taken in this. Now we'll take x4. So again, we have to see the sign. If it is less than equal to, we have to add slack variable. So we'll add slack variable 2x1 plus 3x2 plus x4 is equal to 25. So all this x3, x4, all these are the slack variable. Now for this third constraint. So for the third constraint, we will add x5. And again, we need to add a slack variable because it is less than equal to. So x1 plus 5x2 plus x5 is equal to 35. So all conversion over, x3, x4, x5 are slack variables. Now we'll add those slacks variable over here. So when we are adding this, we will multiply with 0 because that is the coefficient of slack variable in the objective function. So we'll say 0 into x3, 0 into x4 plus 0 into x5. That means what? This slack variables will not add anything into a z function, objective function, because we are multiplying by 0. These are all the variables just to solve the example. But actual variables are only the decision variables, which is nothing but x1 and x2. Okay, so now after this, this will be our constraint, x1, x2, all these up to x5, all should be greater than equal to 0. So we have done conversion. Once we finish with that, then our next step is draw the table or solve the LPP. Okay, so this step is very important and you should not do any mistake along in that. Okay, so writing with the table now. Now here we'll write down the CJs, coefficients of the objective function. Here all the coefficient of the objective function. So for x1, 6, for x2, 8. So 6, 8, and remaining all slack variables, it is 0. Okay, now we'll start with the first iteration, or we will say initial iteration. So initial iteration is nothing but whatever our these constraints are there, for all these equations, we'll write the coefficients of this. So now always we'll start with the slack variables. We have three equations and we have three slack variables. So here from the first equation, we'll take x3. From second equation, we'll take x4. And from third equation, we'll take x5. Okay. So what is the coefficient for x1? 1. What is the coefficient of x2? 1. What is the coefficient of x3? 1. There is no x4 and x5 in this equation, so it will be 0, 0. So this many times we have done, and this RHS is 10. Same way, for this, from this equation, we'll write down 2, 3, this is 0, but x4 is 1 and this is 0. This is 25. Now for the next equation, we will write it down. So this is our initial iteration, okay? So once we finish with the initial iteration, I mean just we have done the setup. What? This is nothing but XB, basis variable. This is called as basis variable. And for this, what are the CJs? 0, 0, 0, right? In the objective function. Now what we need to do after writing all this, we have to calculate ZJ. So how we'll calculate ZJ? This into this plus this into this plus this into this, right? So it will be 0 in the initial because all these are 0. So if you multiply with anything, it will be 0 only. So all ZJ will be 0. And this for this also we have to do, that means 0 into 10 plus 0 into 25 plus 0 into 35, so we'll get it as 0. Okay, so after this we need to calculate CJ minus ZJ. So CJ minus ZJ is nothing but 6 minus this 0, so it is 6, 8 minus 0, so it is 8, and here it is 0, 0, 0. So this is over with our first iteration or the initial iteration. So always understand, here you have the basis variables, whatever the basis variables here you have, for that always we'll get the identity matrix. We should get an identity matrix. You can see over here 100 010 001. It is identity matrix, so we'll get. And also you have to see that when we'll get the values for CJ minus ZJ, we'll always get for this basis variable, we'll always get CJ minus ZJ and 0, 0, 0. If we are not getting these values at 0, 0, 0, we might have done somewhere some mistake and we have to rectify that mistake. Okay, so in the second color, we can see that. Okay, so now first we have to decide in the next iteration which variable is going and which variable is leaving. So in the next iteration, which one is leaving, which one is entering, right? So now to find out that whatever our CJ minus ZJ is there, so these values are there. Among these values, we have to see which one is maximum positive. Okay, we will only concentrate on positive values, not even zero, only positive values. So here we have 6 and 8. Among this 6 and 8, which is maximum? 8 is maximum. That means what? In the next iteration, this variable is entering. This variable means which variable? X2 is entering. So if X2 is entering in the next iteration, which one will be leaving? X3, X4 or X5? So for that we'll calculate theta. How we'll calculate theta? Theta is equal to RHS divided by corresponding element of entering. You are listening, right, Rajita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, yeah. Entering variable. Okay, so corresponding elements of entering variable. So this is the entering variable, right? So these are the corresponding elements. So what we need to do? RHS divided by these variables. So 10 divided by 1, 10. 25 divided by 3. So we'll write it down as 25 by 3. And 35 divided by 5. So it is 7. Now how much this will come? This will come somewhere, it is 8 point something, right? It will come somewhere 8 point something something. That means among this theta, which one is lowest? The lowest is 7, because this is 10, this is 8 point something, this is 7. So lowest is 7. So this variable is leaving. This variable is leaving means which variable? X5 is leaving. So in the next iteration, instead of X5, we'll be having X2. Okay, so now we'll go for the next iteration and we'll write down x3 will be at its place, x4 will be at its place, but instead of x5 we'll be writing x2, and then we'll write its coefficient for x3 0, for x4 0, for x2 it is 8, so we'll write 8 over here. So once we have written this, then we'll try to put its matrix. Okay, so now we'll try to write down its matrix. Now this is living variable, so this row is the pivot row and this element is the pivot element. Why it is pivot element? Because it is intersecting element of living row and entering variable, right? So this is a pivot element. We can just mention it as PE, pivot element. Okay, and this is pivot row. The complete row is a pivot row. So now when we'll go with the next iteration, first we'll find out for this x2 and not for x3 and x4, because x3 and x4 are there in the previous iteration also. X2 is the new one, so first we need to find out for x2. How we'll find out for x2? Pivot row divided by pivot element. So 1 divided by 5, 1 by 5. 5 divided by 5, 1. 0 divided by 5, 0. 0 divided by 5, 0. 1 divided by 5, 1 by 5. And 35 divided by 5, 7. So we'll get this. So once we finish with x2, then we go for x3 or x4. So let us go for x3. Now how x3, when we need to calculate the new values of this x3. So what formula we should use, we have to find out. So to find out the x3, we'll always take old x3 and we'll take this newly entered variable. So in this iteration, the newly entered variable is x2. So we'll take this newly entered x2. Now we need to find out what formula we can put. Okay, so to find out this, we have to do simple thing. See, here we have x3. So x3, here we should get 1. Okay, and now here we have x4. Now, so x3, x4, we should get 0. And we have x2, so x3, x2, we should get 0. Only x3, we should get 1. So these values we should get, whatever formula you use over here, but we should get these values. By using which rows? By using old x3 row and new x2 row. Okay, so old x3 row means this. New x2 row is nothing but this. And by using these two rows, we should get this value by putting some formula. Now we'll concentrate here, we want 1. So if we do 1 minus 0, we'll get 1. Same thing if we do minus 1 minus 1, we'll get 0. Same thing if 0 minus 0, we'll get 0. That means if we do a simple subtraction, we are getting the required values. So we can go for this formula. So for remaining also we'll do same thing. 1 minus 1 by 5. So 1 minus 1 by 5, it will come as 4 by 5. So we'll get this answer as 4 by 5. And same thing here also we'll do. 0 minus 1 by 5. So we'll get it here as minus 1 by 5. And here also we'll do the same thing. 10 minus 35. This will be 10 minus 7. So 10 minus 7 will be 3. So here we'll get it as 3. So we use same formula and we have found out remaining all values for this row. So now this row is completed. Now we'll go for x4. So to find out the x4, we have to take old x4 and new x2. Okay, So if you have finished, I'll scoop right. We'll take to find out new x4, we'll take old x4, and we'll take new x2, and we'll find out what formula can be best fitted. Now see, x4, x4, we should get 1. X4, x2 should be 0. And x4, x3 should be 0. So we should get these values. Okay. Now we should get these values by using these rows. So old x4 is this middle row. And new x2 is this row. Right. So let us concentrate over here. Just see where we want 1 first. Here we want 1. So here we have 1. Here we have 0. So 1 minus 0 if we do, we'll get 1. So it is okay. Now check same minus we can do. 0 minus 0 if we do, we'll get 0. Okay. Then check over here. 3 minus 1 if we do, we'll not get 0. Right? Same formula, if minus we apply, 3 minus 1 will not get 0. That means what? We cannot do a simple subtraction. Even it is possible for this, even it is happening for this, we cannot do because it's not working for this. So now what to do? Now see, here we have 3, here we have 1. If we multiply this 1 by 3, and then if we subtract from this 3, we'll get it 0. So that means what? I'm saying multiply this x2 by 3 and then you subtract from x3. Okay. So if you multiply this x2 by 3 and then if you are subtracting, we are getting here 0. Right? Multiplying this 1 by 3, subtracting from 3, so it will be 0. Now same thing. Multiply this 0 by 3, it will be 0. Subtract from 0, it will be 0. Now same thing. Multiply this 0 by 3 and subtract from 1. So 1 minus 0 into 3 is 0 only. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So now it is correct. That means we can go for this formula. So now same thing. Multiply this 1 by 5 by 3 and subtract it from 2. So 2 minus, we have to do 3 by 5. So it will be 10 minus 3 by 5. So it will be 7 by 5. So this will be 7 by 5. Right? Now same thing we'll do over here. So we'll multiply this 1 by 5 by 3 and we'll subtract from 0. So it will be minus 3 by 5. Now here also, multiply this 7 by 3. So it will be 21, subtract from 25. So 25 minus 21, it will be 4. So this way, by using like this little bit, we have to work out on this part. By doing this, we'll get the matrix element for this iteration, right? Once we get this, then what is the next step? Find out the Zj. So this into this, this plus this into this plus this into this. So it is nothing but 8 by 5. Here it will be 8, here it will be 0, here it will be 0, here it will be 8 by 5, and here will be 8 into 56, because 0 into 3 plus 0 into 4 plus 8 into 7, which is 56. And then we'll do Cj minus Zj. So Cj is nothing but this top values. So 6 minus 8 by 5. So rough work you have to do always. 6 minus 8 by 5. So 5 threes are 30 minus 8 divided by 5, so it will be 22 divided by 5, right? So this will be 22 divided by 5, and then 8 minus 8, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 8 by 5 is minus 8 by 5. So this is over with the second iteration, right? So this is over with the second iteration, but now what we need to find out, we have to find out with respect to the which elements is entering and which elements is leaving. So we need to find out now that. So we'll go for that. See, now which element will be entering? First we need to find out that. So by looking at the Cj minus Zj value, always only with respect to positive values. See here, this is 0, 0, 0. No need to check anything. Minus negative value, don't bother. Only positive value is this, 22 by 5. That means in the next iteration, this variable is entering. Which is this variable? X1 is entering. Now we'll find out which one is leaving. So to find out which one is leaving, we'll find out theta. So theta is nothing but RHS divided by corresponding elements of the entering variable. So 3 divided by 4 by 5. So 3 divided by 4 by 5 is 15 by 4. So this will be 15 by 4. Right? Then 4 divided by 7 by 5. So 4 divided by 7 by 5 is 20 by 7. And next is 7 divided by 1 by 5. So 7 divided by 1 by 5 is 35. So these values will get. Now from this, which one is minimum? Here also when we will check for the minimum values, we will check only positive and zero values. We will not bother about the negative values. So here which one? 15 by 4 is nothing but 3 point something. But 20 by 7 is this, right? So this is the lowest. So 20 by 7 is nothing but 2 point something. And 15 by 4 is nothing but 3 point something. So this is lowest. So as this is lowest minimum, this will be leaving. As this is leaving, what is the pivot element? 7 by 5. Is the pivot element. So we'll just make it and we'll say this is our pivot element, right? Now moving to the next iteration. So you can see over here, this Cj minus Zj will get 0, 0, 0. For which variable we got 0, 0, 0? X2, X3, X4. So it is correct, we are going correct. So now we'll go to next iteration. So now in the next iteration, instead of X4, we'll write in X1. So remaining is as it is, X3 instead of X4, X1 and X2. Their coefficients are for X3 is 0, for X1 it is 6, for X2 it is 8, right? And now we'll write down, we'll fill this matrix. So to fill this matrix, first we'll start with the pivot row divided by pivot element for X1. So this is pivot element, this is pivot row. So 7 by 5 divided by 7 by 5, 1. 0 divided by 7 by 5 is 0. 0 divided by 7 by 5 is 0. 1 divided by 7 by 5 is 5 by 7. And minus 3 by 5 divided by 7 by 5 is minus 3 by 7. And this is 4 divided by 7 by 5, which is 20 by 7. So we got all these values, okay? Once we'll get all these values, then next step is going to find out for the either X3 or X2. So start with X3. Now, where we want 1, x3, x3, we should get 1. Then x1, x3, x1 and x3, so x1 and x3, we should get 0. And x2 and x3, we should get 0. So we want these values. Now to get these values, what we need to do? We have to take to get new x3. We will take always old x3. And newly entered variable, in this case, in this iteration, it is x1. X1 is newly entered variable. So we'll take now this and we'll find out the formula. Okay, so now see, we want here 0, we want here 0, and using the old x3, this is old x3 row and this is new x1 row. So see, 4 by 5 minus 1, if we do, will get 0? No. That means what? If this 1, if we multiply by this 4 by 5 and then if we subtract it, then we'll get 0. So if we multiply this 1 by 4 by 5 and if we subtract, we'll get 0. Then can we do same thing here? If we multiply this 0 by 4 by 5 and then subtract from 0, we'll get 0. Same thing here. If you multiply this 0 by 4 by 5, it will be 0 only. And then you subtract from 1. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So we have to multiply this x1. Right, this x1 we have to multiply by 4 by 5 and then we have to find out. So now let us find out for this left out 1. So for left out 1, multiply this 5 by 7 by 4 by 5. So 4 by 5 into 5 by 7. So this will get cancelled, 4 by 7. And subtract those 4 by 7 from this 0. So 0 minus 4 by 7. So this will be minus 4 by 7. Okay. And same thing we'll do for this also. So multiply this by 4 by 5. Actually minus 4 by 5, right? So we'll get it as here as 1 by 7. Right? And same thing here too. Multiply this x1 means this value by 4 by 5. So it will come as something and that you have to subtract from this x3. So this value will come as, this one will come as 5. Okay. So if you do calculation, it will come as 5. So we got all the values for x3. Now we have to work on x2. So to work on x2, let me just clear this. Okay, now let us clear this one also. So now to find out x2, what we have to do? We have to take old, to find out new x2, new x2, we have to take old x2 and we have to take newly entered variable, that is x1, right? So we have to take newly entered variable, that is x1, and we have to find out the formula. So what formula we can find out? Now where we want 1, x2 will get 1, x2, x1 will get 0, x2, x3 we should get 0, right? So to get this by using this, so what is old x2 row? This is the old x2 row and this is the new x1 row by using this. So just check, here we have 1.5, 1 divided by 5 and here we have 1. So if you multiply this 1 by 1 by 5 and if you subtract it, you will get 0. If you multiply this by 1 by 5 and you subtract from 0, you will get from 1, you will get 1. And again same thing, that means it is very clear, if you multiply this 1 by 1 by 5 by 1 by 5 and if you subtract from here, you will get the required values. So we'll do the same thing. You multiply this 5 by 7. Okay. So once you finish with this, all this, then what we need to do? We have to find out the ZJ. So ZJ is this into this plus this into this plus this into this. So here it will be 6. Here it will be 8. Here it will be 0. Here it will be, if you do all those calculation, it is coming as 22 by 7 and here it will be minus 2 by 7. Okay, so and here when you will do 0 into 5 plus 6 into 20 by 7 plus 8 into this. So this value will get it as 480 divided by 7. Okay, so then we'll do Cj minus Zj. So Cj minus Zj, Cj on the top, right? So 6 minus 6, 0, 8 minus 8, 0, 0 minus 0, 0. This will get it as minus 0 minus 22 by 7 is minus 22 by 7, and this will get it as 2 by 7. So if you find out here now whether algorithm will stop, if we don't have any positive value then algorithm will stop, but we have here zeros, here minus, and here we have one positive value. So still the algorithm is there. So that means what? In the next iteration, this is entering. This is nothing but x5, last variable is entering. So in the next iteration, if x5 is entering, which one will be leaving? So now which one is less? The less is 5. So as the lesser is 5, this is leaving. That means what? In the next iteration, x5 is entering, x3 is leaving. So let us find out, go for the next iteration. Okay, the coefficient for x5 is 0, for x1 it is 6, for x2 it is 8. Now first we'll calculate the, what is element, pivot element is 1 by 7. So first we'll find out by x5. X5 is nothing but this row divided by pivot element. So 0 divided by 1 by 7, 0. 0 divided by 1 by 7, 0. 1 divided by 1 by 7, 7. 4 by 5, 4 by 7 minus, divided by 1 by 7, minus 4 by 7. So it will be minus 4. And here it will be 1. And here it will be 5. Right? Now we'll go for the next one. Now when we go for the x1, x1, x1 should be 1. X1, x2 should be 0. X1, x5 should be 0. We should get these values. So to find out these values, we'll be taking, for finding out the new x1, we'll be taking old x1 and we'll be taking newly entered variable, which is x5, right? So we'll take this and we'll find out the this. Now concentrate, this is newly entered variable, sorry. This is newly entered variable, and where is old x1? Old x1 is this one. Okay, where we want 1? We want 1 over here. So 1 minus 0, 1 we are getting. 0 minus 0, we are getting 0. But minus 3 by 7 divide minus 1, we are not getting 0. That means if you multiply this 1 by minus 3 by 7 or 3 by 7, then you will get it as 1, right? So we can multiply this by 3 by 7 and you can do plus, okay, because you are multiplying this 3 by 7 to this, and then if you are doing same way, you have to find out now for this. So to find out for this, again we need to change the formula. We have to find out the formula. So we'll just, see, we need x2, x2, 1, we need x1, x2, 0, we need x2, x5, 0. So these values we need. And for this, to get this new x2, we'll take old x2 and newly entered x5. We'll take newly entered x5, right? These things we'll be taking. So now concentrate this old, this new, this row and this x2 row, this row. Right, and find out 0 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, but 2 by 7 minus 1 will get 0, no, that means what, this 1 if you multiply by 2 by 7 will get 0, if you multiply this 0 by 2 by 7 and subtract it from 1 will get 1, so 2 by 7, so that means here if you multiply this x5 by 2 by 7 and then if you subtract it, you will get the required value. So here you will get minus 2. And here, so let us go for zj and then cj minus zj. Zj is nothing but this into this plus this into this plus this into this. So here it is 6, here it is 8, here it is 2, here it is again 2, here it is 0, here it is 70. Now if you do cj minus zj, 6 minus 6, 0, 8 minus 8, 0, 0 minus 2, minus 2, 0 minus 2, minus 2, 0 minus 0, 0. So now check whether do you have any positive value. You don't have any positive value. That means as there is no positive value, the algorithm terminates. We don't have anything to go into a next iteration. So as there is no positive value, the algorithm stops. Now, from the last iteration, this x1. So for this x1, what is in the RHS? 5. For this x2, what is in the RHS? 5. So this is the answer. So for x1, it is 5. For x2, it is 5. And for z, the last iteration, what you got over here? 70. So z is equal to 70. So this will be your final answer, which you need to highlight. And you can check whether this 70 is clear or not.